हे गाइस, माय नेम इज़ अनुराधा। वेलकम टू आवर चैनल जी की गाइडेंस एंड नॉलेज। हैप्पी मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इम्पैक्ट ऑफ डिजिटल रेवोल्यूशन ऑन ह्यूमन वेलबींग एंड कैपिटल। टुडेज कोटेशन इज, यू कैन लर्न समथिंग न्यू एवरी डे इफ यू लिसन। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर एसे। इम्पैक्ट ऑफ डिजिटल रेवोल्यूशन ऑन ह्यूमन कैपिटल। The entire nation has joined hands to make the dream of the digital India into reality. Youngsters are enthusiastic, industry is supportive, and the government is proactive. India is yearning for a digital revolution. Narendra Modi. Said by Narendra Modi, digital revolution starts from the discovery of computers by Charles Babbage. He also considered as the father of the computer because he invented the programmable computer, and in 1936, during the World War II, Alan Turing broke the German Enigma code through his invention of computer based on different patterns. After that, computer transformed throughout the 5 generations, and now it is digital and accessible by every part of the world. Digital means using online technologies to improve services for people and business. It also means using data and technology to redesign and how government works, and technologies with data used to rethink how we deliver value, how we operate, and our organizational culture. It also helps us to deal with issues easily, provide information, and make us digitally capable. Then, positive impacts. We all know that every coin has two faces. So there are some positives and negatives. Let's discuss from positives. Positive impacts of digital revolution on human capital is it helps to develop so many capabilities with the help of digital platforms. We can take education as well as we can provide knowledge to others. Information about any issue, solution, government policies, laws, data about anything easily accessible from any online source. Through strong internet connectivity, we can solve issues of verification of various kind of documents and make payments digitally and spread awareness everywhere. During pandemic, in lockdown, we face so many problems. Shutdown of businesses negatively impact their production, supply and delivery of work. To resolve this problem, we start work from home. Through this, 37% of work done with safety. School, colleges and other institutions start online classes to resolve the health issues. Doctors start online consultations with patients. Several organizations like WHO, SAARC, BIMSTEC and so many others, and various countries, bilaterally, trilaterally and collectively, make their strategies through video conferencing. It also helps us testing and monitoring of patients, and with the help of various apps, like in India we use Arogya Setu. Human capital is stock of habits, knowledge, skills, intelligence, health, education, training and other things employers value, such as loyalty, punctuality, ability to perform and communicate with others, new opportunities to communicate, share knowledge, skills, and effective utilization of knowledge as human capital. Human capital is backbone of economy. It need to be improved with the time and technology. Digital revolution provide opportunity to connect the whole world. Human capital doesn't show the balance sheet of the company, but without human capital, company doesn't survive. It helps in various sector of society and help to develop a country and the world. We can see through development of science and technology, we are able to eradicate issues of agriculture, medicine, space, water, pollution, measurement, defense, human health and well-being, industry, transportation, environment and conservation of various birds and animals through using it. Its contribution in human capital development is indefinable. Through digital media, we can share talent, experience, innovation, ideas, knowledge, skills, and inspire others to build their own human capital. We can see some examples of transformation of technology from big size computers to laptop, and now we can access all the things from a small smartphone. Second example is currency. It starts from barter system. Metals, paper, then cards, and new one is cryptocurrency. Third example is digital transformation of theater, street shows, dramas converted in cinema and OTT platforms like Netflix, Amazon, Hotstar. It also provides remote area problems and solutions. So here we can discuss negatives, positive and negatives. We can discuss negatives now. We can see due to increased use of easy access to everything, people spend more time with digital gadgets. Screen time increased, less interaction with elders and others. Example, commonly we can see during traveling, most of the people indulge in their phones rather than interacting and watching natural beauty of outside. Throughout more exposure of screen, some people get lazy, continuously scrolling unwanted things and spend the whole day on phone rather than doing any productive work. On the other hand, due to exposure of blue light of smartphone, our sleeping time reduced because at night everyone needs sleep to regenerate energy and freshness. It interrupted blue light, reduced the release of melatonin, sleeping hormone, and we face sleeping disorder. People related eyes problems, headache that cause migration in long term, body distance disbalance due to lack of exercise like overweight and health issues. It also affects children and elders. Elders feel isolated due to less interaction and hard to use and handle the technology. When parents do their work and child disturb them, they simply give phones to the child. It building gaming habit of children rather than taking knowledge, and we can see small children wearing glasses due to this. Parents continuously post their children's picture on social media. Invitation to the criminals like kidnapping and forced prostitution of children take place. Cybercell expert also raised this issue recently. Today, child pornography is easily accessible on internet and provoke them who have that kind of mindset to make crime. Similarly, women are also vulnerable. Firstly, they have less access to these devices. If they have access, then criminal mindset people start exploiting them through messaging, calls, negative comments, try to stalk them digitally, send nude and vulgar pictures, and then start blackmailing, ask money and other things. We can see so many cases related to cyber crimes. So after analyzing all these things, we can say that if we want to see success in digital revolution and improve human capital, then we have to focus on growth of positive things like education, skill development, training, data information. With that, we have to eradicate negatives by reducing screen time, extensive internet use, and health issues. This happens with maintaining balance between the digital life and social life. It helps us to do multitasking, skill learning, effective response, and provide opportunities to us. Also need to work for vulnerable section like elders, children, women, with the help of proper training of police personnel, cyber security cell, and police reforms. We can end with this. Effective utilization of digital revolution make India digital. So this is it for today. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.